Hi, I'm Carly McAvoy. I wanted to show you a review of solving equations with fractions. Coming into Math 99, you should be very comfortable with solving linear equations, but sometimes solving the ones with fractions can trip people up a little bit. The method I'm going to show you is to multiply by the least common denominator to clear the denominators out, then solve the equation by simplifying both sides, then using the multiplication and/or addition properties of equality as needed. And then, of course, you can always check by substitution. All right, let's take a look at the first two problems. Again, you could always work these just by keeping the fractions in and solving them without clearing out the denominators. This is the method I'm showing you because I find people have more success with it. But certainly, if you're confident with working these your own way, then do that. The least common denominator for this problem is 12. So I'm going to multiply everything by 12. I'm saying 12 over 1. And then 3 goes into 12 4 times. 2 times 4 is 8. 4 goes into 12 3 times. 3 times 1 is 3. I have the x there. And then 2 times 12 is 24. Notice that 2 gets multiplied by the LCD even though it did not have a fractional part. I would subtract 8 from both sides. I get 3x equals 16. And dividing both sides by 3, you get x equals 16 thirds. And I will leave the check to you. Just plug in that 16 thirds for x, and you can see that that would see if that would work out for you. Okay, so then the second one, I just have one fraction in here, and I could distribute this through and work it that way, but I think it'd be easier to clear out the fractions, and so I'm going to multiply both sides by 3. Here the 3's cancel to 1, so I just have 4, 5x plus 1, and then I have 24. So the idea of multiplying by the LCD is to get rid of those denominators and make things easier without the fractions. Distribute through here, and I'm going to simplify this. I'm going to get 20x plus 4 is 24. I'm going to subtract 4 from both sides and get 20x is 20. And dividing by 20 on both sides, I get x equals 1. Again, I'll leave that check up to you. We can plug that back in and see if 6 times 4 thirds would indeed be 8. And it works out. Okay. A little bit harder fraction problem here. We have something with denominators all the way through. We've got a fraction inside here. We can't clear that fraction out in that first go through. We can only get rid of the fractions outside the parentheses. What's the least common denominator for the 3 that are outside the parentheses? Well, it's 24. So I'm going to multiply everything times 24. The thing to remember that this is one large term. So when I multiply this term by 24, I'm already affecting that parentheses as we go. So 24, 8 goes into 24 3 times. 3 times negative 3 is negative 9. 3 goes into 24 8 times, and 8 times 2 is 16. And then 8 goes into 24 3 times, and that's negative 15. Now I'm going to go ahead and distribute this 16 through, and when I do 16 times 7 eighths, if you can't do that in your head, you can do it off to the side, but you should see that 8 goes into 16 twice, so I get 14. 16 times 4, I always get that one wrong, 64, I always want to say 48, which is times 3, and then over here I have negative 15. So now I'm going to simplify negative 9 and 14 is 5. Then I'm going to subtract 5 from both sides. This should be commonplace for you, the rest of this. And I get negative 20. And then divide both sides by negative 64. And when I do that, I get x on the left. And the two negatives make a positive. And 20 over 64, what's the greatest thing that goes into both of those? Is it 4? So you would get 5 sixteenths, or you could call it negative 4 and think about it that way. 20 divided by 4 and 64 divided by 4, and so we get 5 sixteenths. And again, you can plug that in to check it. Whoops, I went off screen here a little bit. Sorry about that. 5/16 is our final answer. Let's look at the last one that I wrote. Actually, give me a second here. I forgot to tear it off and I can't move it. Okay, the last one that I wrote on here looks like this one. And your problems may be a little different, but the idea that we're getting to as you get into these higher classes is that you can take a concept and apply it to a slightly different type of problem. So you may not see exactly the type of problem you have on your homework, but the idea is there, and that is figure out what the LCD is and multiply everything by it and then continue from there. So the LCD for this problem is 12, so I'm going to multiply everything times 12. 4 goes into 12 three times, so I have 3 times 5x plus 3. The 12s go away, and then 3 goes into 12 four times, so I have 4 times 5 plus 2x. And now you just have to solve that equation. We have 15x plus 9 plus 25. And I am going fast because this part should be something you know, and you don't want to spend all kinds of time watching a video with stuff that you already know. So I have 15x plus 34. I'm going to subtract 8x from both sides. That's going to give me 7x. And I'm going to subtract 34 from both sides. And that's going to give me negative 14. And I'm going to divide both sides by 7. And I'm going to get x equals negative 2. And again, you can plug that in and check it. And since we're to the very end of the video, I'll do this one for you. That is 5 times negative 2 plus 3 over 4 plus 25 over 12 should be 5 plus 2 times negative 2 over 3. So that's negative 10 plus 3, which is negative 7/4. And this is 5 plus negative 4 or 1/3. So let's change this into 12s by multiplying the top and the bottom by 3, and you get negative 21 12s plus 25 12s is supposed to equal 1/3. Negative 21 and positive 25, that's 4. And 4 12s indeed does equal 1/3, so that our answer, x equals negative 2, checks out. So that's how you can work equations with fractions.